Hello everyone, welcome back. Today we are going to discuss about comparative statements. Comparative statements or comparative financial statements means a comparative study of components or elements of financial statements, that is balance sheet and statement of profit and loss, for two or more years or with that of other enterprises. As a first step, each component or element or item of financial statements of two or more financial years is placed alongside each other. Thereafter, difference between the two amounts is determined. And lastly, the percentage change in the amount is ascertained. The statement so prepared is known as comparative statement. When comparative statement of the firm's financial statements of two or more years is made, it is known as intra-firm comparison. And when comparative statement of the firm's financial statement is made with that of another firm or with industry data or with the budget, it is known as inter-firm comparison. Comparative financial statement is a tool of financial analysis that shows change in each item of financial statement in absolute amount and in percentage, taking the amounts for the preceding accounting period as the base. The data and information compared is presented in a manner that there is no dissimilarity between them, since a comparison between dissimilar data would make the analysis meaningless. Now let us understand purposes of comparative financial statements. Here, first point is to make the data simpler and more understandable. Comparative statement is a statement having data for two or more years in a table form. Thus, it is a simple presentation, understandable and also comparable. It helps in drawing conclusions easily. Second point, indicates trend. Comparative statement gives information about the changes affecting financial position and performance of an enterprise. It is an indicator of trend and thus helps in forecasting. Now, third point, indicates strengths and weaknesses. Comparative statement or comparative financial statement indicates strengths and weakness of the enterprise with respect to liquidity, profitability, and solvency. Next point, comparative statement helps in comparison of an enterprise's performance with that of other enterprises or with that of the industry. Next point, forecasting and planning. Analyzing changes in the financial data of previous years helps the management in forecasting and planning. In comparative statements, the details of income statements and balance sheets of two or more than 2 years are compared. Here is the structure of a comparative profit and loss statement. Statement of profit and loss, or we can say income statement, shows net profit earned or net loss incurred for the year. Comparative income statement shows the operating results for a number of accounting periods, so that changes in data in terms of absolute amount and percentage from one period to another may be known. So let us understand here structure. A comparative income statement is prepared. As you can see, it has six columns. And here in the first column, the items of statement of profit and loss, that is, for example, revenue from operations, that is sales, cost of material consumed, purchase of stock in trade, change in inventory of finished goods, work in progress and stock in trade, then employees' benefit expenses, depreciation and amortization expenses are entered. Now in the second column, note number will be written. In the third column, the figures of previous year are entered. And in the fourth column, the figures of current year are entered. In the fifth column, differences, that is increase or decrease in figures between the previous accounting period and current accounting period are recorded. And then in the sixth column, here in the above difference, the differences, that is increase or decrease, expressed in percentage are shown. Here percentage change is equal to absolute change into 100 upon amount of previous year. This is the formula. Now let us understand the components, each and every components. Here revenue from operate, first is revenue from operations. Revenue from operations is the revenue earned from the principal revenue producing activities, that is the business of the enterprise. It is also known as the operating activities of the enterprise. Examples are sales, sale of scrap, trading commission, cash discount received, then revenue from services, etc. It is the first item in the revenue of the statement of profit and loss. Then next is other incomes. Other incomes are those income which are not revenue from operations, that is incomes which are not the principal revenue producing activities of the enterprise. Examples are rent received, then interest and dividend received, then profit from sale of fixed assets. Then here we have expenses. Expenses incurred by an enterprise and shown in the comparative income statement are, first is cost of goods consumed. It is the value of materials consumed in manufacturing of goods, that is opening stock of materials plus purchases of materials minus closing stock of materials. Then next is purchases of stock in trade. It is the value of net purchases, that is purchases less returns of goods in which the enterprise trades. Then we have changes in stock or changes in inventories of finished goods. Work in progress and stock in trade is the difference between the opening stock and closing stock, that is opening stock minus closing stock. Then next we have employees' benefit expenses. As I have already explained you, employees' benefit expenses includes the amount of wages, salaries, staff welfare expenses, etc. Then we have depreciation and amortization expenses. Then financial cost is there. Financial cost is the amount of interest paid by the company on its borrowings. Then we have other expenses. Other expenses include the amount of expenses other than the whatever I explained you above six heads or of expenses. It includes telephone expenses, selling and distribution expenses, advertisement expenses, cash discount allowed, bad debts, provision for doubtful debts, loss on sale of fixed assets, and loss on sale of investments, etc. So here we will get total expenses. Then after then we have profit before tax. After we will deduct income tax, then we will get profit after tax. So this is the structure of comparative profit and loss statement. Now let us see. A format of comparative balance sheet. See, comparative balance sheet analysis is the study of the trend of the same items, group of items, and computed items in two or more balance sheets of the same business enterprise on different dates. Comparative balance sheet of an enterprise as on two or more dates are used for comparing assets, liabilities, and capital and ascertaining increase and decrease in those items. Such analysis often yields considerable information which is of value in forming the opinion regarding the progress of an enterprise. So here let us see structure here. As you can see, Here we have six columns. In the first column, the components or elements or items of balance sheet are entered. In the second column, we will write note number. Then in the third column, data or amounts of previous year's balance sheet are entered. Then in the fourth column, data or amounts of current year's balance sheet are entered. Then in the fifth column, differences in amounts, or we can say increase or decrease in amounts between the previous year and current year, are shown. Then in the sixth column, the above differences or increases or decreases expressed as percentage are shown, taking previous year's amount as the base. So here our formula of percentage change would be absolute change multiplied by 100 upon amount of previous year. So I hope it is clear to you all. That's all for today. Thank you very much.